Okay, my dream has come true. That's right. Honolulu Community College, in partnership with the University of Hawaii Institute for Astronomy, will be using the Force. That's right. May the Fourth be with you. Now, Mike, right? Mm-hmm. Mike Ferguson and Keith is also here to tell us a little bit more. And as you can see, we are armed and ready to go. But really, we talk about May 4th. It's a great day for Honolulu Community College. What's happening on May 4th? What can people expect down there?
Well, it's an unofficial fan day for Star Wars. And we want to capitalize on a STEM outreach event where we have professors from the Institute for Astronomy come and give Star Wars sort of astronomy-based talks.
Cool.
And we're also having Kehlani Murphy, captain at the Hokulea. She's going to come and give the Hawaiian star chart.
Mm-hmm.
We have cakey activities. It's going to be a lot of fun. Also, Precision Parker.
Wow.
Keith, the gentleman here to my left. he's going to do some lightsaber demonstrations there and here for us right now.
I love it. You know, we're going to get to that in a bit, and I'm really excited about this. But, you know, we're also excited about Honolulu Community College. You talk about STEM. Now, if anybody's not known, I mean, we talk about STEM all the time, but what does STEM stand for, and how important is that really for students?
STEM is science, technology, engineering, mathematics.
Mm-hmm.
We desperately need STEM majors. We really need it. It's what STEM majors help with the cameras here.
Oh, everything.
Programming your cell phone apps. We really desperately need it for our economy.
Mm-hmm. You know, even President Obama came out and said that math and science for the younger generation is going to keep our country competitive going forward. And like you said, we need that. So it's kind of cool, though, how you brought it back, you know, the Hokulea. One foot in the past, but looking towards the future. Star navigation kind of comes all together and around, and it's kind of neat that we have that mix here in Hawaii.
Interesting to say that, because we're talking about going to Mars soon, and we don't have GPS at Mars, so how are we going to navigate there? We're going to navigate using the stars.
Amazing.
So
amazing.
We need that going outside of our planet to explore space.
I didn't even think about that. Yeah, GPS doesn't work there, and our view of the stars on Mars is going to be a little different from what we see here on the Earth. Wow, that's so cool. Again, all the fun that can be had around there. Now, speaking of fun, now this is kind of cool. I'm a huge Star Wars fan, but I've never picked up a real kind of lightsaber like this. Keith, talk about Saber Academy. What's that and what can people expect?
At the Hawaii Saber Academy, we focus on two things.
Okay.
Fight choreography, and then it's really safe because it's you're mirroring your partner.
Oh.
And you kind of can tell a story. With fight choreography, we can also kind of advance into more risky moves because you know what your partner's doing.
Ah.
The other aspect is saber combat sport. So it's not a martial art. We're not actually trying to hurt each other.
Mm.
But it's improvised, and it is slightly competitive in a friendly way.
No, and I've seen it come together. You know, Justin Cruz here at the station, also a big Star Wars guy, but I've seen one of your things, especially when you got the higher level trained guys. It's almost a ballet. It flows, and it's amazing to see. And there's teamwork that really kind of goes on together, isn't it?
Yeah. So there's like we try to build a language of moves, so you understand what's happening, so you can read your partner, and we aim for like the shoulder or the hips, the nice safe parts of our body. You know.
I'm worried that you said that because, again, I'm a huge Star Wars fan, but Srini, the Force is very strong with her as well. So I'm actually going to kind of bring her in, and maybe you can kind of maybe show some moves here and see how Srini and I do. Is it okay if Srini uses her lightsaber?
There you go.
Oh,
that's an honor.
I know. These are the real ones, Srini. All right, Keith, so why don't we go ahead and get you ready?
I'm against Srini, I think the robe better.
Wow. This is serious. Okay, now we're going to have you go ahead right there in the middle, Keith, and I'm going to come on this side.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh. Oh.
We can turn the sabers on. And I heard red is your color.
Okay,
right?
It is. Yes, how'd you know?
So for the basic fight choreography, we are going to do four hits. So it's one, two, and then low, three, four. And these are really strong sabers. They can take a hit, so don't feel free to hit the saber.
Okay, you're going to regret that you said
that. Wait. Did you hit that button?
Yeah, turn it on.
Button right there?
Ahead,
oh, there you go.
Okay.
Ready? So one, two, three, four. Nice. Okay. And now let's try 4, 3, 2, 1. So go low here. Four.
I plug the website.
3, 2, 1.
Awesome.
Excellent.
All right, real quickly, I'm going to jump in. Can I try
to
that top right? And if anybody wants to find out more information, where's the website they should head to?
Okay.
So go to Honolulu Community College's website for more information on the May the 4th event.
Again. One, two.
You can't really hit with these. Oh my gosh,
okay,
this is so cool.
Backwards.
I'm a little scared, guys. I'm gonna actually get away from Trini because I think the Force is strong with her. But again, head on to Honolulu Community College. We have all the information. And really, when it comes to STEM and learning about science in the future, it's the way to go. Pretty good, huh? You think she's
Yeah.
Yeah, the Force is strong with this one. Okay, we're gonna tease out here. Coming out after the break, we'll wrap things up for you. Let you know we have store where the Force comes back after the break. Okay, Trini.